Good morning, students. So this is chapter 7, looping statements. So what is looping statements? So for the multiplication number of times while we are executing a program is called the looping statements, right? So under the looping statements, we have four conditions. What are they? For loop, for each loop, while loop and do while loop. So already we learned about for and for each. Today we are going to say about while loop and do while loop. So what is while loop? The while loop execute a block of code as long as the condition specified in the while statements evaluates to true. So this while loop is also same like that of for loop. It will work. That means the code will be executed if the condition is true. So the first, the while loop will check the condition. The first point here is the while loop will check the conditions, and if the condition is true, it will execute, and if the condition is false, it will exit. Okay, so the flowchart, while we are seeing the flowchart here, they are given. We have three processes. First is initialization. Next, we are checking the conditions. Next is the updation. So same like that of for loop. For loop also have three parameters, right? What are the init count, that is initialization, init counter. We are for checking the conditions, that is test counter, and for incrementation, that is for increment counter. So like that, here we are having three process: installation process, checking condition process, and updation process. So in the initialization process, we'll give the value, like if I equal to 0 or I less than or equal, like that we will give the value in the initialization part. Then we will check whether the condition is true or false. So if the condition is true, the it will execute the code. Otherwise, if the condition is false, it will exit the loop. Then updation, then it will come to the update. That means after the updation, again it will move to check the conditions, and it will check whether it is true or false. If it is true, again it will come to updation, again it will move to the for checking the condition, whether the condition is true or false. So this is the flowchart for the while loop. So see the syntax. So while, and it is, the condition is true. It checking the conditions. Condition is true means the code will be executed. So this is the syntax for the while loop. So we having one example program here. So first we are starting with the PHP. Then we are giving two counts. That means student count equal to 10 and student number equal to 1, and we are checking that is the installation part. The student count equal to 10 and student number equal to 1 is the installation part. Then what is the second step? We want to check the condition, right? So next we are checking the conditions while student number is less than or equal to student count. That means 1 is less than or equal to 10. So the condition is true, so it will execute the statement. The student number is student, for echo means it will execute. That means the executed part, that it will print the statement. Again, it was going to the updation part, that is increment. So student number plus plus. Now the student number will change to 2. And instead of 1, it, I plus plus means 1 plus plus is 2. So again, it will come for checking the conditions, whether it is true or false. So if it is true, means again it will execute the statement and it will print the statement. Again, it will come for the incrementation, and again it will change to 3, and again it will compare with 3 to 10. Like that, the process will go until the condition is false. So after the condition is false, it will execute the statement. So it's same like that of for loop. Okay, then next we are going to see about the do while loop. So the main difference between the while loop and do, here is all while, do while is also same like while. Here is also it will execute the statement. if it is true and it will if the condition is false, it will exit from the loop. But the major difference between while and do while is the while statement will check the condition at the entry place. That means at the first, after the initialization itself, it will check the condition, then it will execute. But in the do while loop, it will check the execution at the exit part. That means at last, it will check the condition. Okay, so in the while loop, it will check the condition at starting itself. After we are installing the value, it will check the condition, then the code will be executed. But in do while loop, first it will execute the code, then again it will check the conditions. So while will check the condition at the entry place, and do while will check the condition at the exit place. So this is the major difference between while and do while loop. So the do while loop is always very similar to the while loop, but executes the block of code at least once before evaluating the conditions. Here the condition is evaluated only at the time of exit of each iterations. So this is the flow chart we are having here. First we will start the loop, then we are executing. Do something means here we are executing or running the code, then we are checking the conditions. If the condition is true, again we are going to the code. Then if the condition is false, it will exit. Okay, so anyway, at least once the execution will be happened in the do while loop, because for starting itself it will execute the code. No, so at least once the execution part will be happened. The syntax for the do while loop is first do, the keyword do, then we are executing the code to be executed. Again, we are checking the conditions. So first we will write the keyword do, again we will execute, and at last at the exit point we will check the conditions. So the example program for the do while loop is we want to start with the PHP, then we are giving two initialization values, that is student count equal to 10 and student number equal to 1. Again do, that means the keyword do, we are executing the statement first. So the student number is and the student number first we are executing the, so what will the in the place of student number, what it will come? 1. Again it will increment, it will become 2. So again it will check while student number is less than or equal to student count. So now it will, the student number, it will be 2. Again it will, the student count will be 10. So here what it will happen means the first itself it execute the statement. No, so in the output part we will get 1 as the output. If it is false means, if again the second number is false means, it will exit from the loop. But the first output we have, no, so that first output we will get in the output screen, because it will give at least once the execution will be happened in this do while loop. Okay, so this is the example program for do while loop. So while loop means it will check the conditions whether it is true or false, and at the entry point it will check the count. And in the do while loop it is also same, it is also check the conditions, but here it will check the condition at the exit place. So in do while we will execute the statement at least once. So this is about while and do while loop, guys. Thank you.